Hi, this is VSDC channel, where we show you how to replicate unusual video effects. Now, put your seatbelts on, because today's tutorial is for those who were asking for the Slenderman effect. Slenderman is a fictional character created by the members of the forum called Something Awful in 2009, and it later became a scary urban legend. According to the legend, Slenderman kidnaps people, typically in the forest, and nobody sees them ever after. For this tutorial, we prepared some materials you can download and a project you can practice on. In the description, you can get 4 videos with a person in the forest and 2 videos with the Slenderman in front of the green screen. Shall we get started? Launch VSDC and import the footage. You'll have to think the scene through in advance and put the episodes in the right order on the timeline. In our case, the scene starts with a background shot of a person walking in the forest, then we'll move on to the middle ground and finally to the foreground with a character's perspective. First things first, convert all the files into a sprite and set the following parameters. Use as container? No. Show effects? Yes. Fill background? No. Make a double click on the sprite, then select the video where you are planning to add the Slenderman. Make a right mouse click on it and create a movement map. If this is the first time you are seeing our motion tracking module and you have no idea how it works, you can watch a detailed guide we published earlier. Select the spot where the Slenderman is supposed to appear and place the tracking frame there. Then hit Start Analysis. If you have multiple videos, repeat these steps for each video. Next, place the video with the Slenderman into the sprite above the video where he's supposed to appear. Make a double click on the video with the Slenderman and apply the background remover effect. Again, if you've never worked with a background remover in VSDC, check out our detailed tutorial, right here. As soon as you finish removing the background, go back to the sprite and edit the position and the size of the Slenderman. Once again, go back to the video file with the Slenderman and add the movement map you created earlier. In our case, the character in the foreground is seen clearly because they are in the focus. Meanwhile, the background is blurred. This means that to make the Slenderman look more authentic, you'll have to apply the Gaussian blur filter to it. To set the blur level to your taste, in our case, 6 is enough. Also, notice that there is a green outline surrounding our creepy monster. To get rid of it, add the hue saturation lightness effect from the adjustments category. By the way, we have a dedicated guide to making colors in a video less visible. You may want to watch it later. Just select the desired color, shift the center control point closer to the center and the side control points further from the center. Go back to the sprite. It's time to start working on the second video. Add the video with the walking Slenderman to the project. Then make a double click on it and remove the background. Add the corresponding movement map. Because the background in this video is also out of focus, you'll need to apply the Gaussian blur effect to the Slenderman just as we did earlier. In this case, the blur level will be 10. Alright, now let's reduce the borderline a bit. Open the Video Effects menu, proceed to Filters and select Minimal. Select any value to your taste, in our case it's 3. Then add the Hue Saturation Lightness effect. Select the desired color, shift the central control point closer to the center and the side control points further from the center. Go back to the sprite and duplicate the video with the walking Slenderman, then place it further on the timeline. Duplicate all the effects from the previous video except for probably the Gaussian blur. Then add a glitch effect and select any preset you like. We go with number 3. Copy the glitch effect and add it to the sprite. Set the duration at 0.5 seconds and place it where the files merge. All we need now is to slightly adjust the look of the video. What you can do is select the original file, go to the Basic Effect window, find LUTs and select Night Dive. Plus, we recommend changing the white balance by adding new control points to the RGB color spectrum. And this is it! We hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and if you have any questions or suggestions, leave them in the comments below. Until next time!